Hey guys, I've had a few hours to try and collect my thoughts and calm down and all that. Just a forewarning, this is gonna be an emotional video. I got a lot of news, well, I got a big thing of news and stuff today, so to get down to it, don't I? First of all, I apologize for jumping, well, for posting in rapid succession. I said I wouldn't blow up your feed or anything, but, you know, it's been a crazy couple days. Let's attempt to start off with the good news. I didn't have to go to jury duty. I'm not sure if I mentioned that in the past video or not, but I didn't have to go. I called the number before and they didn't call my number, so didn't have to get up for that. So that's the good thing about yesterday, if I'm mistaken. Monday. So there's that, but the big thing is, it's difficult to talk about, because, I apologize, but I have a family member who's, I just found out, is pretty much dying. I know she's at least in her 70s, so there's that, but it's one of my aunts. I just got the news today. She apparently has sepsis, and possibly they tested for it, but I'm not sure. I didn't hear anything about it, but possibly meningitis as well. So, but it's been crazy for me. They told me that she would have within the next day, possibly, she would lose brain function, and she only has a few days to live. The only bad thing about that is, she doesn't exactly live close by, so I wouldn't be able to say or do or anything. So, yeah, it's been really messing with me today, hearing the news. So, it was pretty bad. I even had several coworkers and even my boss worried about me. They spotted me breaking down for a minute, and, yeah, they were like, just go home, you know, be with your family and all that. I'm like, what about, I covered all my bases. I said, what about, I don't want to get in trouble for this. I don't want to, the whole point system. I don't want to. I want to stay in work, but I know I wouldn't be able to do it in the condition, the mindset I was in, because all the emotions rushed right through me. Because last time I saw my aunt was at my mom's funeral, which was years ago. I think we've talked once or twice beyond that. I think I called once to check up on her after the funeral, but beyond that we haven't really talked. I guess that's one of the reasons why it, kind of beat me up. I felt guilty for not, calling, contacting, all that stuff, but I guess that's normal. I was told by a good close friend of mine, to not worry, you know, don't let it beat me up or eat me alive about that, because, you know, he was saying, you know, they could have called two and all that. Like, true, yeah. But, yeah, it's just crazy. But, yeah, I was breaking down. I was all that. I mean, they came home early. I bawled on the way home. I did call my aunt and all. Only thing is, I only have one of their phone numbers, so I left a message and basically gave them my contact info and all that. You know, reach out to me and all that. So I can only hope, right? Hope and pray for a miracle. Because, yeah, like I said, the big thing that's tearing me apart is that I hadn't really talked to her, so, in such a long time, because, she was the one who actually taught me how to play chess when I was younger. That actually got me into chess. I mean, I haven't played it in a while, but I still have that same chess set that, she taught me on. Still have that. And, I know her nickname for me was, when I was younger, was Bubba. Because there was a Bubba the Bear thing. I remember I had the little plush bear of it. It was cute. And I'm like, yeah, I can see it. Blue eyes like me. Bigger like me. So, yeah, I guess there's that, but, yeah. You know, I just remember, you know, the good times with her, like when Mom also was alive. Well, when Mom was alive, I used to. She always stayed with my Mom whenever she came to the state and all. And I just remember, you know, we had fun and all that. I remember. My mom had the nice big pool in her old house, and, you know, swim around, all that good stuff. So I played chess. Yeah, even at my old house that actually had in-law suite, or whatever you want to call it, you know, the add-on, she stayed up there with her and all. Yeah. So, yeah, it's been a rough day. Like I said, I came home early. I tried to make a video when I first came home, but I just couldn't. My emotions were just rampant. I ended up just being in the shower crying for a while. So, yeah, it's been a crazy emotional day. But, yeah. You know, with what little good news there's always something harsh following. Feels like. But, yeah. Just wanted to fill you guys in on what's going on and all that. I know that there's other family who wonder and all that, so. But, yeah. Hopefully, I mean, it's freaking huge miracle if anything she pops back is what I'm at least being told and can assume, because yeah, sepsis, possibly meningitis, and yeah, as far as I know, oh yeah, she was also put on hospice as well, so yeah, that's not a good sign either. I mean, who knows? I mean, maybe the hospice worker knows how to do, you know, actually medicate and stuff, you know? I don't know. Because there is times I know, Gia's grandfather was put on hospice, and he was pretty good for a while. So who knows? See, it's a pretty freaking huge miracle if anything good happens. So, but yeah. Wow, that wasn't as emotional as I thought. I guess I'm just kind of numbing out now. Earlier when I made the video, I couldn't stop crying and shit. I mean, it was hard enough for me to say that she was dying. Because every time I tried to say that, my voice, I just broke and was dying. You know? But, you know. Yeah, trust me, I was really bad at work. I mean, what is it, 4 a.m. now? And I'm still, I mean, my head's pounding. Like, I was crying a lot, so, you know, the whole thing when you cry a lot makes your head pound. She has me at work, too. I just felt like someone was, like, crunching my brain. Ugh. But, yeah. Please send your thoughts and prayers and all that my way. Well, not my way, but my aunt's way, if you can. I mean, if you want to throw some my way, go ahead. That's all of you. The good thing is, like I said, I had my coworkers and even my boss be very kind and caring. So it makes me shed a tear seeing hope for humanity, you know. Not even just coworkers, but even friends. Because some of them aren't, you know, they're not just coworkers. I see them as friends. Because, I mean, you know, all of them were just telling me to go. You know, go home. So go to your family. I'm like, I freaking wish I could. I wish I could travel all the way out of state and go see them. But I'd probably need, like, a week off, and I don't really think I could afford that, you know? I mean, I at least I don't have enough paid time for it, and all that, so, because I'd have to travel out there, get a place there, all that stuff, it would just be too much of a hassle, you know? I mean, if anything, worst come to worst, I don't know the whole plan or ordeal. If, you know, she does get worse like that, you know. So right now, she's still there. I don't know what's going on with anything beyond that. I have my one aunt mentioning to me everything, so I gotta play it by ear for now. Because I don't know if she knows that if there would be a service, if it would be there or here, you know. Just gonna play it by ear. So, I know I didn't really look at the camera, but it's just I really don't want you guys to see how broken I am inside. So, I apologize for that. Kind of why I'm pacing around and looking away, because I'm falling apart. I was literally on ESO for hours and all that, trying to keep my mind off. It was still there, back in my head, you know. So, I'm probably just going to take some Tylenol, maybe put in another game or something, relax for a tiny little bit of time. Try to pass out, because, yeah, it's been a rough evening, because I found out she messaged me about, earlier this evening, about 5, and I was fine at work till after lunch and all that, about 10 o'clock, I think I clocked out around 10:15, and that's when, it was around 10 o'clock when, because I went in at 3, got the text around 5, and, I was okay for a while, and then, you know, I was, you know how it builds up over time, you know, believe me, it was bad when I left. As soon as I got in that car, holy shit, the waterworks flew. I was driving, bawling my eyes out. Good thing is, it was, like I said, it was 10 o'clock at night, nobody was really out and all that good stuff. I mean, I wasn't swerving or anything, I was very fine, you know. Because you know when you blink, the tears fall out and all, so. I mean, no shame, I fucking cry. So. Don't believe that bull crap where people can't cry, men can't cry and all that. Show yourself. Be yourself. You hurt. Say you hurt. Don't be afraid. Believe me, I've bottled so much pain up. So much pain up. You know, hell, I lost my parents. And I tried so hard not to shed tears all those years. Until now, pretty much. What a handful of tears came out tonight, more than ever, mostly because all those backed up tears. So yeah, don't do that. It's hard. So just end up destroying yourself from the inside out. Tell that to my kid one day, you know. Don't be like me. Be better than me. Whenever I do have a kid. So. Anyways, I'm just gonna digress from all that. So yeah. I'm just gonna relax for the evening. Take it in stride. Try to pass out soon. Because, you know, boss. I told boss I'd be okay tomorrow. So. I had this evening to just let it all out, and I'll even have later this morning, afternoon, whatever, for work, to be fine. I think I'm okay right now, so, just gotta wait it out, see what goes on, you know. Alright, so anyways, guys, thank you for hearing my whole spiel. Emotional thing, you know, memories, I guess coping, all that life advice. So, have a great night. Like I said, I'm gonna try and pass out real soon. I don't want no more of that 7 o'clock nights, please. And again, who can blame me with all this stuff going on, so. Anyways, look forward to hearing from you guys. Like I said, send thoughts and prayers, if not, well, I keep trying to say to me. Not to me. I mean, sure, it'd be nice to have me in your thoughts, but I send them towards my aunt, hopefully. Hope, you know, big miracle hope and all that. She'll pull through. So yeah, I'll be posting, at least some point soon. Alright, later guys.